Singapore has a long history of incorporating nature and greenery into urban development. Green infrastructure, best seen in the vegetation surrounding the Singapore Management University, is part of the larger scale planning involved in making sure a successful city in nature exists. These trees play a role in providing shade and regulating temperatures from the urban warmth generated by cities. In Singapore, for example, the difference between temperatures in downtown areas like Orchard Road, with its forested surroundings, can be up to 7 degrees Celsius at night. More trees in its built-up areas can lead to a considerable reduction in this urban versus rural temperature difference, as green spaces transpire moisture, don't store excess heat in the day, and they do not emit waste heat, such as from air conditioning sources commonly found in Singapore. The green infrastructure also enables water to enter the soil and reduce the risk of flash floods, which, despite Singapore's best efforts to adapt to more frequent and intense rainfall brought about by climate change, is still rather high. These spaces allow water to enter into the ground and can be channeled to drains and rivers rather than pooling at the surface and contributing to flash floods. Park spaces abound in Singapore, as well as conscious design and planning that integrates nature with the urban. The presence of such urban greenery allows for spaces in which our students, faculty, and visitors can engage and reconnect with nature and its biodiversity, such as the verdant vegetation, on an everyday basis. Furthermore, urban wildlife, like the otters in Singapore's waterways, urban roosters, and other animals, allows us urbanites to come face to face with nature here in the heart of the city. While Singapore is a small island, it has a big environmental footprint, especially on a per capita basis. We import all of our energy, as well as most of our food and other resources. One aspect that needs addressing in being a sustainable city-state is the requirement to stop using fossil fuels as quickly as possible, especially since emissions from burning these fuels is the key factor behind global warming and climate change. More than 50% of our greenhouse gas emissions are from energy generation and its usage throughout Singapore. Although it is difficult in Singapore to source for renewable energy due to our small size, cloudy weather, and lack of wind, solar energy is our best bet. Every little bit helps. And here in SMU, we have the largest solar farm in downtown Singapore, generating up to 1.35 megawatt power of electricity, reducing our annual campus energy consumption by 7.5%. Singapore's building sector has a large environmental footprint and will continue to do so in years to come. Buildings play a role in reducing carbon emissions, and the new SMU Connection building heralds the start of a new way of sustainable building and construction of infrastructure. It is built by using mass-engineered timber as an alternative to concrete, reducing emissions as the wood stores carbon as it matures naturally before being harvested for prefabricated construction material. Unlike concrete, using mass-engineered timber as construction material also stores this carbon during the duration of the building's lifespan. Furthermore, the SMU Connection is also a net zero energy building, utilizing some of the PV energy generated on campus, and is Singapore's first net zero energy building in the city center, applying new building technologies, which helps enhance the sustainability of the campus, is a key step forward in Singapore's actions in dealing with the climate emergency.
Urban greenery is a key component of modern urban cooling strategies. But this is by no means a new concept. Parks, gardens, roadside trees have long been used as means of providing shade and improving thermal comfort. This was aligned with 19th century concepts of health and well-being, ones that connected intimately to the Garden City model, proposed by then social reformers and public health specialists, such as Edwin Chadwick and Ebenezer Howard. These principles were well known in Singapore's history and were iterated many times by national leaders too, including the late Prime Minister Lee Kuan Yew. Singapore Management University is embedded in this green past, situated on the original botanic gardens that were developed in the 1820s. This garden, designed as much as an economic research facility as a park, provided the urban centre with much needed green space for a few decades. And today, the area has been revitalized to reveal the urban core's connection to its environmental history. Embedding our university, or indeed any business, within its historic environmental past allows us to reconceptualize urban working. It connects heritage with green solutions and connects us with our past, present, and future of urban living. This leads to greater public awareness of environmental challenges and solutions, as well as a deep understanding of integrating nature within the city. As we talk about climate change and the uneven impact of temperature rise on modern cities through the urban heat island effect, it's also interesting to note that the SMU campus has a connection to the types of climate records from which modern-day scientists build long-term temperature models. Our university has a hidden past. It was built over one of the original meteorological registering stations on the island, originally located in a 19th century convict jail, built to house prisoners transported from other parts of Asia back in the days when Singapore was a British colony. Weather records were made at this jail from 1869 until well into the 1880s. And this is an important record, not only because it provides very early climate data for the island, but because of the city centre location. Such records are critical for building climate models to understand the pace of climate change, and especially urban climate change, from a time when the city was far less developed. History is a key route by which we can engage and educate employees, stakeholders, and the general public in green initiatives by grounding place in past, present, and future. History offers us a way of bringing the past to life and offering context to our modern challenges and solutions.